How do I get the narcissist out of my life? I get that question a lot, and I really understand the question. So many experts on narcissism tells you to leave them out of your life and go no contact and block them on all social media. However, for some people that just doesn't work. Sometimes narcissism and stalking goes hand in hand, unfortunately. The narcissists are known to harass people, and there's a mindset of the narcissist that we need to talk about. The mindset that once you are in the narcissist's life, you are his or hers forever. You are their property. You are their thing. You are their tool. You are their supply forever. And that means that in their head, they own you, and they can come back and come back and come back to reignite or re-trigger or try to be a part of your life again and be really, really invasive. And they are so sneaky. They have a lot of ways to get back into your life. So what I'm going to tell you is not what you want to hear, unfortunately, because you want them to get out of your life. But it is actually you who has to do something, because the narcissist has a mindset that tells him or her that they are entitled to be in your life and be part of your life and expect you to give them supply. And they will trigger you in any way they can. So what you need to do is to get them out of your life. Yeah, you need to be the one to get them out of your life. I know that you, in some countries, you can actually press charges or report them for harassing you. And you should do that. You should tape everything they say, conversations. You should take screenshots of conversations where they threaten you or demean you or belittle you. You should be sure to record things. You should save emails they send you. You should document the exchange you're having with the narcissist. And if they lurk around your house or they come to a place where you are without being invited, please record them on your phone with a video and then go to the police and ask to have them reported for harassment. That way they will have a court order or something similar to stay away from you. And that is actually one of the only ways you can do this. The other day I had an American client in a session, and she had fallen in love with a foreigner. I'm not going to say what country he was from, but they had a boat together, and she actually chose to tell him, "You can have the boat and sail away on one condition: promise me to never come back to this town again." And that was the way she got him out of her life. But she had to go to that extent. I have known other people who have been forced to report others to immigration to get them out of their lives. But it is you who has to do something to get them out of your life. They are not gonna leave voluntarily. So don't wait for them, and don't expect to find an answer to how do I get him or her out of my life. No, you have to be the one. You have to be proactive. And just remember this one little thing. But before I tell you that, please click subscribe and support the channel. You think that you are being unkind if you're reporting them, if you're getting them deported, or, you know, if you're taking them out of your life, if you're taking drastic measures to get them out of your life. You think you're not a nice person, you're not a kind person, but you are, because the person in the world that is the most important person to take care of is you. You have to take care of you. And if you don't do that, then you are not kind. Then you are not self-loving. Then you are not smart. Be smart. Take care of you. Make sure that you have a good life, that you have a happy life. You deserve it. Okay? Take care. See you soon again.